In this video, you will learn how to use Mixamo Auto Rig in Blender 5 with the Mixamo Rig 5 add-on. We will cover character rigging with and without IK, animation retargeting, manual animation editing in pose mode, timeline keyframe control, and control rig shape customization for a clean and efficient animation workflow. I will go to the Mixamo platform and download one of the ready-made characters. It is a completely free platform, and I logged in without any issues. First, I will choose a character from Mixamo. I personally like the XBot character. I will also add animations to the XBot. I selected the XBot, and now I'm moving to the animations section. Let's choose an animation. From the animation list, I'll select idle, because we will mainly talk about rigging. I download this animation with skin. Now I will download another animation, and this one will be a run animation. Now I'm in Blender. I clean the scene. First, I'm going to install the add-on. For this, I click Edit Preferences. After that, I click Install from Disk and install the Mixamo Rig 5 add-on. As you can see, Mixamo Rig 5 has been installed. So where is it? I press N in the viewport, and it appears in the right side panel. Now it's time to import the animations into the scene. I go to File, Import FBX, and import the animations. First, I import the idle animation. Right now, the Mixamo Rig is not active. When I select the armature, the panel becomes active. First, I play the animation to check it. As you can see, the animation works perfectly. Now, I can start the rigging process. I select the armature and click the Create Control Rig button. A new panel appears. Basically, there are two options here: rigging without animation and rigging with animation. I will explain both in detail. First, I want to show rigging without animation. If you don't select Apply Animation, the character will automatically be rigged in a T-pose. So how do we control this rigged character? From the top left panel, switch to pose mode, and now you can fully control the rig system. I'll slightly reduce the panel size. For example, if you want to move the hands, you can select the hand and move it however you want. You can do similar operations on the other arm, or make adjustments to the waist, or control the hips, which affect the entire character. By pressing R, R rotation, I can rotate it however I want. So what are these spheres used for? The spheres above control the elbow movement. By pressing G, you can manage the elbow position using these spheres. Now I move to the feet and test the controls. As you can see, everything works very smoothly. Now I undo these changes. Let's move on to the second part, rigging with animation. I select the armature again and click Create Control Rig. This time, I check Apply Animation in the panel. With IK arms and IK legs enabled, I click OK. As you can see, the character is now rigged with animation. I play it. The character is both rigged and animated. I restart and watch the animation. So how do we modify the character's movement? Again, I switch to pose mode. The entire rig system is now color-coded and very easy to understand. We created the setup using the most stable and readable colors. Now I'll make some small adjustments. For example, I want to move the character's hand. I press G and move it in the desired direction. I can rotate the torso to different angles, and I can freely move the feet as well. Let's look at this in more detail. Just like the spheres I mentioned for the shoulders, there are also spheres for the knees. These spheres give you full control over the knee direction. You can change the knee orientation however you want. So how do we edit the animation itself? Here's how. When you press the record button in the timeline, you can start modifying the animation. For example, I want to adjust the character's left arm. I select the arm. For each selected rig controller, its corresponding keyframes appear in the timeline. I want the arm to stay slightly more outward. I select the frame range where I want to make this change and delete those frames. Then I will add new keyframes in that empty area. Since record is active, Blender will automatically add keyframes for the new movement. I press G and raise the hand a bit. As you can see, a new keyframe has been added. Now the arm goes up and then comes back down. I want the hand to stay higher, so I press G again and raise it more. A new keyframe is created in the timeline. You may notice that after the last keyframe, the arm suddenly drops down. To fix this, I need to delete some of the falling frames as well. This creates a much smoother transition. You can intervene in any part of the character. For example, the head is looking to the right and keeps looking right. Starting from frame 106, I want the head to turn toward the camera. I select and delete the frames in that range. Notice that only the selected rig controller is affected. I delete the frames between 105 and 135, creating a smooth transition. I also want to change the head movement. Around frame 120, I rotate the head by pressing R plus Z. Now, until frame 121, the head turns in the desired direction. As you can see, within the specified frame range, the head moves exactly how I want. You can make any adjustments this way. One important thing to note, the frames shown in the timeline belong only to the selected rig controller. If I select a leg controller, you'll notice the timeline updates. When I click the head again, only the head's keyframes appear. Now, let's also edit the foot animation. Starting from frame 108 until around frame 133, I want the right foot to stay in the air. So I delete the frames in between. I move to frame 120. Press G and lift the foot. It starts on the ground, rises until frame 120, and then goes back down. I play the animation, and it works exactly as intended. That's the logic. You can manually intervene in any animation using this method. Now let's move on to the next section. Retarget animation. I switch back to object mode. I want to reset the animation on this character. For this, I click the Zero Auto Rig button. When I do this, the character automatically returns to a T-pose. After switching to T-pose, we can freely adjust the character again. However, I want to transfer a different animation onto this character. I will bring the run animation that we downloaded earlier into the scene. This process is very simple and can be done with a single click. I imported the run animation into the scene. I move the character to the side using G plus X. As you can see, a new keyframe appears in the timeline. The reason for this is that record mode is still active. I need to disable it. First, I undo the changes I just made. Then I turn off the record button. This step is very important, so please pay attention. After disabling record mode, I bring the character back into the scene. Now my character is in the scene. I move it aside using G. I move the timeline back to frame 0. Now I want to transfer the animation to my rigged character. This process is very simple. All I need to do is make sure my rigged character is selected. Then on the right side, I select the eyedropper tool and click on the animated character. You may notice that in the source skeleton field, the armature name of the animated character appears automatically. After that, I click Apply Animation to Control Rig. That's it. Now both characters are moving together. This is exactly how animation retargeting works. Rigging without IK arms and IK legs. Now I will explain another feature. I select the armature and click Create Control Rig. The panel opens. You may not want to use IK arms and IK legs. If you want to work fully manually and control everything yourself, you can disable both of these options. Now pay attention to the newly created rig system. It is slightly different. There are more rig shapes available, and you have full control over the entire skeleton system. We can intervene in a similar way as before. I switch to pose mode and move closer to the character. As you can see, there are two separate shapes on the arms. These are completely rotation-based controls. You can change their orientation however you like. I zoom in further and start adjusting the hands and fingers. All finger rigs are already set up and ready. In the same way, you can move the legs using rotation controls. You can also perform these adjustments using the rotate tool on the left panel. With the rotate tool, we can freely manipulate the rig. Similarly, I can also adjust the feet, customize rig shape. Finally, I want to talk about the customize rig shape feature. I open the Mixamo Rig panel. I select the character's armature and click Create Control Rig. In the panel that opens, I choose to work with IK enabled, so I keep IK arms and IK legs selected and press OK. After that, I switch to pose mode. Sometimes the shapes or sizes of the rig controllers may not look good to us. In such cases, we may want to customize them. For example, you may want to change the hips control shape. I select the shape and click Edit Control Shape. Once I click this button, the shape becomes editable. I can scale it up or down, or even change its form. Using G, I can move the corner points and reshape it. For example, I can turn it into a triangle pointing in the direction the character is facing. After completing the adjustment, I click Apply Control Shape, and now the shape appears in its new form. It looks a bit ugly. I only did this to demonstrate the feature, so I undo it. Sometimes a character's hands may be very large and the control shape can get lost. In that case, we can easily scale up the control shape. I select the shape, scale it to the desired size, and click Apply. Now I can use the larger shape comfortably. You may want to use a smaller control shape for the knees. You can also reposition control shapes. For example, if you want the head control shape to appear higher, you can move it upward using G. Or you can move the hips shape downward. If you don't like the changes you made, you can always revert to the original shape. You can even move control shapes outside the character if you want. This way, you can fully customize your rig using Mixamo Rig. As the Mix and Nemo team, our goal is to provide you with the most practical tools and make animation easy and accessible for everyone. Best regards.